friends, my name is Jen and I make anime figure related videos every single week. So today we will compare two of Hatsune Miku's more popular prize figures, the second season spring version or Easter Bunny Miku figure, and the Sakura Miku 2019 figure, both made by TAITO. I won't be able to compare boxes this time because these Hatsune Miku figures came in a plastic package. So that's one of the things you need to look out for already. Ask the seller if the Miku has a box, and if it does not, ask why. This is to clarify if the box is just damaged or it has no box to begin with. But anyway, this is what the Miku's packaging looked like. Let's open the Sakura Miku first. Let's start with their bases. There's a hint right away already. The bigger one on the right is the authentic Sakura Miku base, while the little one on the left is for the fake Sakura Miku. Notice that when we turn the bases side to side, even though the base of the real Sakura Miku is old already, it's still a lot clearer than the base of this supposedly brand new fake Sakura Miku. The fake's base looks so used and has scratches already. Another thing to notice is that the fake's base doesn't have the manufacturer and other details carved or printed on it. When we turn at the back, notice that there are more holes for the peg on the fake Sakura Miku's base. I don't even know why, but yeah, that's one of the things to look out for too. Alright, time to compare the figure details. Let's begin with the flowers printed on the bangs. The fake Sakura Miku has a clear flower printed on her hair, which is pretty different from the real Sakura Miku's sort of blurry looking flower. The twin toes are removable with the real Sakura Miku figure by TAITO. Meanwhile, it's not really like that with the fake Sakura Miku. Both her pigtails are securely glued on her head already. Here's a closer look on the right pigtails. The grainy looking hair on the left is of the fake Sakura Miku. Honestly, figures made by TAITO are not the best, but these bootlegs are just way worse. The colors of the ends of their pigtails differ as well. The real one looks closer to translucent, while the fake Sakura Miku on the left is more of pink, while trying to replicate the semi-transparent effect. The flower at the ends of their pigtails look the same with the flowers on their bangs. Did the sculptors of the fake Sakura Miku simply forgot to cut out this part right here? Let's compare the cherries next. The fake Sakura Miku has bright red cherries, while the real Sakura Miku on the right has her cherries almost pink. The headset on the authentic Sakura Miku is painted with different colors too, while the one on the fake Sakura Miku is painted with light brown only. Her arm sleeves has details the same as her standard Hatsune Miku arm sleeve design, while the bootleg doesn't. Let's find a difference up front this time. First, the color of the fake Sakura Miku has a darker shade of pink than the real Sakura Miku. The tie clips has less space between each other on the fake compared to the real Sakura Miku and are much darker in color too. On her left arm, the authentic Sakura Miku has her signature vocaloid number 01, while the fake doesn't. So this is what the back of the authentic Sakura Miku look like. Clean, and the details of her outfit has a good sculpt. Now let's look at the fake Sakura Miku. Look at this mess! This is what you prefer on buying? It's honestly a total waste of money. It's like I painted this. The thigh highs of the authentic Sakura Miku has white rectangle details on the knee part, and the color is a bit lighter compared to the fake Sakura Miku. Notice that the peg of the real Sakura Miku figure is a pink frosted-like acrylic, while the ones attached on the fake Sakura Miku are painted white. So this is the face of the real Sakura Miku. Not perfect as you can see, but she looks absolutely adorable. Now this is the face of horror. Look at this yandere Miku. You wouldn't want this in your collection. The brows are painted darker and the eyes are not even. Here's a size comparison of both figures side by side. Now I bought the fake Sakura Miku for $6 in conversion, not including the shipping fee, while the authentic Sakura Miku was $14. I understand, the fake is much cheaper, however, the details are the worst. It's such a waste of money. Alright, let's compare the Easter Bunny Miku next. First, the head can't be detached with the authentic Easter Bunny Miku, okay? I brought that up because I received its fake counterpart with the head detached from the body. Another sign to look out for in buying a fake of this specific figure. Here's another easy hint. This is the base of the real Easter Bunny Miku. It has Easter-related prints on it because it's one of the Miku figures made by TAITO for their seasonal Miku theme. Also, notice that it has a round shape and there are details about the manufacturers at the back. Now, this is the base of the fake Easter Bunny Miku. It's clearly a copy of the Sakura Miku base I showed you earlier. The base obviously isn't round and it has no prints whatsoever. Again, the base looks cloudy and used despite being supposedly brand new. Now here are the Easter eggs as their accessories. The eggs on the right are fully painted. It's the Easter eggs for the real Bunny Miku. The set of eggs on the left is not only painted half-ashed, the colors were also positioned wrong. Okay, so one thing that's easy to spot for fake figures are the sheen of their plastic. It's so shiny it's almost comparable to Barbie dolls. Now I don't know if all the fake Easter Bunny Mikus are like this, but this is just mocking the buyers already. It doesn't even slide back in the body. Please don't choose bootlegs just because they're cheaper. They're just trying to hoax you in exchange for crappy figures like this. The corners of the ribbon attached to the fake Bunny Miku's waist is round while it's pointed on the real Easter Bunny Miku. Also notice that the color of the fake Miku on the left is peach, while the real Easter Bunny Miku's skin color is almond milk. Just like the fake Sakura Miku, the arm sleeves of the fake Easter Bunny Miku is also painted darker than the original color of the real one. The ribbon on top of the real Miku is curved and the daisies are flat and painted neatly. Now the ribbon on the fake Miku is more like angled than curved, and the daisies are molded thicker too. The back of the fake's ears are smoothened or at least a bit polished, while the back of the real Easter Bunny Miku's ears has rough surface trying to replicate a fur. Also notice that the twin tails of the real Easter Bunny Miku changes colors midway to bottom, while the twin tails of the fake Easter Bunny Miku are totally different from the hair on her head. Lastly, their faces. Again, the details are not even on the fake Easter Bunny Miku, and the colors painted on her are more saturated than the authentic Miku on the right. Clearly, the real figure is superior here. She looks better in every way. Listen, when figures are made by Taito and Banpresto, clearly it's not worth it to buy their bootleg figures anymore. The price tags are not even that far, and you're better off saving and waiting a little bit for the authentic ones. It's much worth it than buying a fake figure that won't even last long and comes to you in a crappy state. Alright, I think I covered everything, but if you think I missed something else, please tell me in the comments below. If you think this video was helpful, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, always choose to be kind, and see you on my next video. Bye!